Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, I will show you how I painted this little forest here. I will show you how I built up different layers that I used here and how I put in all the details. I'm Toby. This channel here is all about showing you how to draw and paint. So make sure you hit the subscribe button here not to miss any new episode. Here we started with the underpainting in oils, as you can see. And after this layer is dry, we start to build up the second layer and see me putting in the color in a stippling effect, basically using a ragged old brush here, a very stiff one, and see me putting in the color in this stippling effect. And with this way of putting in the detail, you are able to put in the details much faster, and you don't have to put in every single dot by itself, but you can just put in 10, 15, 20 dots, detail dots by one brush stroke, more or less. It's a pretty quick way of getting in some pre-details after the underpainting is done. Now the second part is I put in the branches, you can see. Colors pretty much thin down. And you also need some color variation in this stage here, as you can see. Some branches are lit by sunlight, some are in the shadows, and yeah. That's why what I built up here now. And you also want to put in the darker part on the branches that are lit by the sunlight. Some of the branches stick out, as you can see. And after that I start to build up the leaves. And you see me putting them on pretty randomly. All kinds of directions, sizes, shapes, and also different colors, as you can see, lighter colors, darker colors. And this is a very important step, I think, to invest the time you need to put in to get this fine little details in, especially on the top part here, where they're pretty dominant and pretty visible at the first glance. And this process takes a while, but I think it's worth to invest the time for this thing here. And the same goes on the left side, where we have the darker part from the background. And I think this gives the impression of much more detail than there really is. You can of course put in those fine leaves everywhere, but I think it's not necessary on the whole painting, and this method here saves a lot of time, basically indicating the details on this darker side here and letting the rest of the tree on the right side here without these fine little details. Also putting in some lighter colors, darker colors, and always this randomness and the shape and size and directions of those leaves. Here I'm adding some more detail, some darker tones, or more or less in a dry brush technique, because the stippled color is already dry. I thinned it down with water and it's pretty much dries instantly. And this here is now I poke in some holes to indicate some windows where you see the background color, the sky more or less. And this is a very important aspect when it comes to painting trees. They look much more realistic when you put in these details here. And it's also time consuming, but without it, it looks just like a mass of green stuff and wouldn't look realistic. And with this way, putting in some windows to the background, you know, I'm putting in the leaves on the darker part here, and you have to see that I use different color variations. Some lighter tones, some darker tones here, to more or less get this leaves connected to the background. And here you see me putting in some pretty yellowish color here compared to the color that I used on the right side here. And this is, I think, a very important aspect, that you need definitely some color variations. And I think you pretty much can't go overboard with this thing. You see, it's a pretty yellowish color here, and when you see the painting as a whole later on, it is not really yellowish. It's a little different color than the rest of the greenish leaves here on the right side. But this helps the painting to achieve this realistic look. And here I also put in some darker tones, some colder tones, some lighter tones, all kinds of color variations. Here, for example, some dark greens. And also try to let them fade out into the black of the background here. You know, I'm building up the window on the left part. Basically putting in some little branches and some little trees in between. And you see that I'm using a darker color than the color that I used for the underpainting, so that the branches stand out a little bit. Not too strong, but they need to be a little bit more darker to get them stand out. Same goes here. I'm using pretty dark color for the leaves here, but I also use some thinned down color, some bluish tones here for the cold and shadowy parts for the other leaves. As you can see here, these are over here, some darker tones and some more bluish, lighter tones to get in the color variation that you need to achieve this realistic effect. This whole thing takes a while to build it up, but I think it's necessary, especially when you have this contrast with the background. You need to put in these details, and therefore you have to invest the time to put those in. Here again I put in some more leaves on this dark part here. And again, the key is to get in some lighter tones and some darker tones and color variations to build up this thing that it's at least come to the foreground, more or less, like on this part here. And some darker greens to fade into the black of the background here to get this impression of death. I'm using a pretty small brush, as you can see here. Also again trying to get in these leaves as random as possible. In all kinds of directions. Left, right, small, big, and yeah. Takes a while, but I think it's worth the time you invest. That's the finished painting. As you can see, the painting is not yet finished here, this part here, and that's the topic for next video. I'm gonna show you how I painted the grass here. Meanwhile, you can have a look at this video here.